Assalamualaikum students, again welcome to our remaining portion of the previous topic, respiration system. I hope all of you will enjoy this part 2. Before starting our today's discussion, I want to remind all of you that we ended up our previous topic till different types of respiratory diseases, and the diseases were pneumonia, tuberculosis, bronchitis, asthma. We discussed only the names of these diseases in the previous video session, but now we are going to discuss the symptoms, remedy and prevention of these diseases in this video session. So let's move on our next slide. Students, in this slide, what are you seeing here? You are seeing a girl is coughing. Her lungs are infected very badly. One type of bacteria called tuberculosis bacteria has infected her lungs. So she is affected with TB infection. So the name of this disease will be tuberculosis, bacteria infected disease. Let's see the symptoms of this disease. Increasing body weight, cough with bleeding, evening fever and night sweating, pain in chest and back, occasional stomach disorder, remedy. Nutritious food, physical treatment, prevention, BCG vaccine, keeping the patient separately, burying the spit and cough of the patient under soil, using handkerchief, keeping the children away from the patient. These are the symptoms, remedy and prevention of tuberculosis disease. Let's see the next disease. Students, here is a boy or girl. Actually, it's a baby. But the baby is sick because its trachea is infected very badly. Actually, one type of bacteria has infected its trachea too. So the baby is suffering from respiratory problems. What will be this disease? This disease is pneumonia. It is a bacteria infected disease too. Symptoms of this disease will be cough and breathing difficulties, high fever, becoming nostril wider during inhalation, constant pain in chest, remedy, nutritious food, physical treatment, especially taking liquid food in a sufficient amount, prevention, keeping the children safe, trying to avoid taking too much cold food or drinks. So let's see the next disease. This is the picture of another disease. This picture shows you that in this disease, the trachea becomes narrowed down. Mucus is stored in the pipeline of trachea and it hinders the respiratory systems of us. So, human beings face respiratory problems. This is also a disease, and this disease is bronchitis. This is not a bacterial disease. It is a disease which has happened due to the attack of virus. Symptoms of this disease: coughing, respiratory trouble, fever, weakness, remedy, stopping smoking, doctor's advice is very important remedy of this disease. Taking rest, prevention system, eating the healthy diet, washing hands, trying to avoid taking too much cold foods or drinks. It was the common prevention system of bronchitis and pneumonia. So these are the symptoms, remedy and prevention of bronchitis disease. Let's see the next disease. I think all of you are very familiar to this photo. Many of you have faced these problems too. Sometimes, some of your friends become sick due to the attachment of dust or woolen cloths or allergic foods. They face the respiratory problems after being attached or being touched with these things. This disease is called asthma. The most important saying of this disease is it is not an infectious disease. It cannot transfer from one person to another. Let's see the symptoms of this disease. Extreme breathing problem. Sometimes coughing, vomiting may be occurred, weakness. Remedy will be avoiding dust and smoke, using well-ventilated or lighted house, taking medicine. Prevention of this disease will be avoiding woolen cloths, not taking allergic food items, giving up smoking. Students, in the previous session and up to the previous topic, we have discussed about the respiration system of human body. Now we are going to discuss about the respiration system in plants. Students, all of you know that the plants take carbon dioxide from the environment and prepare food, and thus they help us by giving food and also oxygen. How is the oxygen produced? This oxygen is produced automatically while producing its food. This oxygen is very essential for all of our human beings. We respire with this oxygen. We take this oxygen to our bodies to break down the stored food in cells into energy. Do you know this oxygen has an important role in the human body with the plant's body too? The plants need sometimes oxygen to continue its function inside its body. When is it necessary? It is necessary while its respiration system too. Actually, the food making system of plants is called photosynthesis. The plants has two types of system: respiration system and photosynthesis system. Through photosynthesis system, it creates or makes its food, and through respiration system, it breaks down its stored foods into energy like us. So as we take oxygen during respiration system, the plants also take oxygen during respiration system of its own self. The plants has oxygen inside its body while photosynthesis, that means at daytime it doesn't need to take oxygen from the environment, but at night while its photosynthesis system is off, it needs oxygen and it takes oxygen from the environment like us. You can examine this system easily. You can lie down under a big banyan tree at night and you will face a little bit suffocation at that time, because at the time both the tree and you are taking oxygen from the environment, so there will be a lack of oxygen at that region at the time. It is clear that respiration system is same in plant body and human body. So let's see a picture about this. This is a picture. This picture shows you that the tree continues both photosynthesis system and respiration system. Photosynthesis system is shown here with white colored arrows, and respiration system is shown with red colored arrows. Here in photosynthesis system, you are seeing that sun is giving its light to the green leaves, and the green leaves is making glucose, Actually, glucose is its food inside its leaf with the help of the sunlight and chlorophyll. While producing its food, it produces oxygen too, which is not necessary for itself at a large amount like us. So it gives us oxygen through stomata to the environment. What is stomata? This picture here is a small picture shown, which shows you the stomata portion of leaf. It is a small pore which helps us in gaseous exchange of plants. Actually, this picture shows you a clear idea about respiration and photosynthesis. In respiration system, energy is produced by breaking down the food inside the cells of a plant, and the energy is at the form of heat energy. So I think all of you are clear that photosynthesis system of a plant continues only at daytime, and respiration system of a plant continues 24 hours of a day. So let's move on our next slide. Boys and girls, this slide is only for thanking all of you, because you all have cooperated me a lot in this session. Hope you all will complete the worksheet very attentively. So thank you again, and that's all about our respiration system.